Hi, I'm Mike Hudson, Director of the Museum of the American Printing House for the Blind. Our Monday mystery object this morning is the Optacon. This lovely little device here. It's in a black aluminum case, maybe 8 inches by 6 inches by 2 inches high. On the front, it has a little inset place where you're going to place your finger. I'll explain that in a minute. And then on top is a little bracket that holds the camera unit, right? So the Opticon, the name itself stands for Optical to Tactile Converter, Optacon, right? So it was invented by a guy named James Linville in California, but about 1970, his daughter had lost her vision and he was looking for a way to turn print material into something that she could read. He actually worked with a company called Telesensory, and the Opticon actually was introduced in 1971. It was made for about 25 years. It's pretty cool. So what you do is you take your camera unit and you slide it over the top of your print material, right? Like a book or anything like that. And what it does is it takes a picture, uses a camera, it takes a picture of whatever it's going to turn into tactile form, and then uses a series of little pins down in this little fingertip hole. You'd put your finger in there. So as your camera goes over the letter A, it would raise the pins into the form of the letter A. People who became good at using the Opticon really loved it because it was one of the first devices that gave you total independence. You were in control of converting whatever was out there in print into a form that you could read. And people loved that, and people became very good at it, at using the Opticon to quickly read. Now, it had some problems. It was really loud. So if you were in a library and you were trying to use the Opticon and it was buzzing and clicking along, people didn't like that too much. Also, it really depended on your ability, your the sensitivity of your fingers and your understanding of what print looked like. If you'd never read print before, if you'd been blind all your life, then you were going to have to learn, just as you would learn Braille, you'd have to learn the shapes of the letters. But Opticon stayed in production until 1996. Finally, it went out when they stopped making it because they said sales were low. And that's pretty true of a lot of these devices for people that are blind or low vision. If you're trying to make a fortune making these kind of devices, you're probably in trouble. But the Opticon still has people out there all over the country that love it and use it. And if there was an Opticon company fixing them, they would be great customers.